In this video, I want to show you how to create a sampling grid in QGIS, how to create a fishnet over your study area. So let's go to QGIS. In QGIS, let's bring in our study area. So click on Layer, Add Layer and Add Vector Layer. So navigate to your folder where you have your study area. In this case, this is it. Click on Open and click on Add. Click Close. Yes, I have my study area here. The essence of this exercise is to create a fishnet or sampling grid over this study area. With that, I'll be able to subdivide my study area into grids such that it will be easier for me to sample. So to do that, after you have brought in your study area, one thing to note is that your study area, this layer must be projected. So you can confirm that by right click and open the properties. So come to source. Here you can see the coordinate system is UTM zone 32 knots, which means it's a projected coordinate system. So let's close this. Now to put the grid, come to processing, click on tools. So come to vector creation, this one, click on the drop down to expand it. Here you will see create grid, double click to open it. Here you can see under parameters, grid type, click on the drop down and choose rectangle polygon. Then grid extent, click here, click on the drop down, you can see different options. So if you want it at the extent of the map canvas, you can choose map canvas. And if you want to draw on the map, you can click on map canvas, then draw the extent you want it to be. So I want it to be like this. After you have drawn it, leave it so it will capture the rectangle you drawn on the canvas. Then here, the horizontal spacing, I want it to be 500 meters. Then the vertical spacing, I want it to be 500 meters as well. Here is the unit. This is where you change the unit. I want it to be a meter, 500 meters by 500 meters. Then the grid coordinate reference system, I want it to be the same as my data. So here, if you want to change it, you can actually change it. So after that, the grid, which will be the result, you can create as a temporal layer or you can navigate to your folder where you want to save it. Then after that, you click on run. So it has run and it has created it. Click close. You can see it has created grid of 500 meter by 500 meter cell size around my study area. So come to the grid created, right click and come to the properties. Come to symbology and here let's make it hollow and click on OK. So you can see it has created grid of 500 meter by 500 meter around my study area, which means I can now work on each of these grids individually if I don't want to face the study area as a whole at the same time. So I can choose to work on this grid today, tomorrow I work on this grid, next tomorrow I work on this grid, or I can give each grid to each enumerators. So in essence, this is how to create grids on your study area in QGIS. Like this video and subscribe. Thank you for watching.